Hello, and welcome back to my RP1 campaign on hard. Got a couple upgrades to spend. That's nearly equatorial. Still equatorial. Okay, that's nearly polar. But I want the three crew. Yeah, okay, that's cool. else can I? Oh, I guess there's no reason not to just take that contract. Oh, wait. Phobos Landing pays better than. Yeah, Phobos sample return should pay more. Well, I'll take this because we have to land. Yeah, those numbers are. Oh well. Okay, we no longer have any contracts that pay for Earth orbital science. Kind of sad. Give me better H1, but that's all. Seven. Ah, the J2S. Definitely worth upgrading to that. It's cheaper. Okay. What new science do we have to play? Let's see. Okay. We've still got, even UHF, we have tons of bandwidth, so that's fine. Okay, so let's look at our new toys. Bigger experiments. Bridge lift power 2. Red. TV camera. And spectrometry. Okay, so this is going to be Surveyor 7. 5 kilogram. That's 5, 6 kilograms. Wait, how is there possibly torque? Oh, that's why there's torque. Because the other thing is physicsless, and this is not. That's why there's torque. Okay, sure. Okay, so what are the power requirements? Let's see, this uses 5 watts. Oh, I guess we can. With avionics enabled. Oh, it's near Earth, so they're always enabled. And a single solar panel gives us quite a bit of wattage. All right, so after 3 years, still breaking even. So that's fine. The other thing to consider is whether I even want the solid in there or not, because I think I want to send this to broadly speaking, low Earth orbit. I'll send another one to high Earth orbit. Real question is there a way that I can get this to be entirely in space high? I don't think there is. Not without using a larger launch vehicle, that's for sure. So, what do I actually want to do? Okay. That's acceptable. And now, let's see, I need a calculator. Oh no, the satellite calculator that I've always used is now offline. That's sad. So there's this now. That's eh, that's cheap. Okay, let's check our delta V. I'm pretty sure the fairing should actually. All right. Let's see what kind of delta V. Plenty of delta V. guess we'll build another one of these to go to the moon. Well, about it later. Okay. Please don't smile. Yeah, I haven't used it since the RF fix, but like, it doesn't have to be exact. I'm not trying to do this to get into an exact orbit. Basically, I just need to make sure that I end up in space high throughout the entire orbit, which I can fairly easily do, given that it, even MechJeb's most pessimistic assumption is about 100 meters per second more delta V than I need. So. Check out it's 66 days. Okay. So Stone Smile, yes, I agree that MechJeb's worst prediction is not the worst because it doesn't care about specific impulse, but it assumes the entirety of the random residuals rather than the average case. That'll dwarf the however, like, half a percent change in impulse that we'll actually have. Also, there's the fact that, yeah, like I said, we have 100 meters per second more delta V than we actually need, like 1588 versus 1470-something. So I'm quite confident we'll be okay for that. All right, so pull that one out. Okay, and we should have delta V. I think I want to go to like a 2,000 or 3,000 kilometer orbit, probably. Definitely want to launch into. inclination we want to go to. Nine degrees. Okay. Do that. Eighty-six. Seven. All right, so almost 700 meters per second. So we need to leave about 700 per second. Let's try that. Interesting that I underlofted that one. Don't usually do that. Blown much worse than these Thorolikes. That only barely got warm. inserted. Okay, we could have gone higher. But 2200 is fine. That's good enough. Thank you. Okay. All right, 90 days for a bunch of that stuff. Let's turn off warnings. Okay, well, short stream, but I'm getting kind of sleepy, so I'll call it quits there. Thank you for everybody watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.